Whoa, is this thing on?
Hello there, everyone. My name is Luna. If you already do not know, this is a Luna Does a Vlog thing where I, in fact, do that wonderful vlog thing. It's been quite some time since I've done one of them. I don't know if the last one I did is when I talked about wanting to kill myself, because that got me tons of fucking trouble in my personal life. And that's why Luna never talks about his feelings. Ever. Or just says constant negative shit that seems to be hanging on him for years upon years on end. But no, today's video isn't going to be about being replaced by someone, and how you leave and you're sliding in the situation and taking over my role. It's nothing regarding that. No. This episode's definitely not about the most important person replacing you with someone. Today's episode's actually about my work, and me working, and my job, and experiences doing that shit, so fucking let's go. So, about 2 months ago, I ended up getting a job. It was a gas station job. I have the job still, and I am in turn still working there. I actually have to go work there in about 2.5 hours to go do the night shift and closing. This is my first ever real job, nothing doing some dumb community service thing, or doing something for a week, or helping out a friend, or pet sitting, or doing anything like that. A legit job that gives me healthcare, and I pay taxes on, and all that wonderful things like that. It's a gas station job, and it's also a faux pizza place. I work the kitchen, I've worked the front, I've worked every which way in that place. I know how to do majority of everything, and I've only been there for 2 months. I'm still regarded as the new guy. Everyone calls me by my first name and not my last name, which is fucking weird. I've had issues with people, bad coworkers, people getting fired, and whatever it may be, being taught by people who know they're gonna be replaced by me. At first, it was absolutely miserable. Me being used to standing. There's no sitting. There's barely any time to sit because you're working, because it's a gas station and people coming in and out. People want food. We're supposed to have stuff every single hour. All those things like that. We're supposed to meet a specific bare minimum. And you could do more. And if you do more, it makes time fly like a motherfucker. But if it doesn't, you're standing there and you're feeling your knees and your ankles and everything else just kind of slowly want to tremble away. I felt that. I was completely miserable. My knees locked up. The pain of standing for such a long time when you've never done it before is pretty fucking terrible. Your feet pound, your feet ache. Just, you start getting veins and you it's fucking gross. Your body rejects the idea of standing. I can't really sit cross-legged anymore because it hurts my knees. But the job itself isn't hard. It's a kitchen job. I run the kitchen by myself. I make over 15 menu items, I think, and I think there's, I make over like 20 menu items or something along those lines, and I also have to stock the freezer, and I also have to take out the garbage, and I gotta clean, and I gotta move all the equipment, I gotta take the equipment apart to clean it, whatever it may be, moving shit that slides, and in turn it has also sliding drawers, and it likes to lock your fingers in and rip the skin off your finger, because that happened in the first 3 weeks. I ended up getting a burn in my arm. You could kind of not see it, but there's a scar, a remnant of it. The job within itself is dangerous, and you need to pay attention constantly. You can't... Working fast is like... It's... You work smart, not fast. Like, that's the idea. I went into the job interview telling the lady that I'd never had a job before, and pretty much telling her the truth about everything, and she took a chance on me, took a chip on me, and hired me. And that was absolutely wonderful, because this is a place that I've always wanted to work. I've always wanted to work at a gas station just because it's a little bit more laid back, and you end up laid back. I ended up dealing with a lot of customers. I do deal with a lot of customers, but not as much as people do up front. I do not like working up front. I like working in the back. I like making pizzas. I like doing everything like that. But the lady who hired me definitely put a lot of belief in me and throwing a lot of stuff on me that I'm starting to do a little bit of managerial work. Doing like the bare minimum when it comes to that, and then also helping managers and just rezoning everything, and it's just been actually pretty fucking cool. The people I work with are mostly older than me, and there's only one person who's a little bit younger than me, and he seems to be pretty fine, no issue there. I was able to get a PS4 Slim, and I was able to buy a cool Galaxy Tab A, I was able to buy a stand for my fucking camera for the first time. Getting all that stuff has been actually pretty cool. Be able to accumulate stuff that I needed to be able to fix my room, to be able to get a new dresser, be able to get tools to possibly make a new dresser. Like, it's been fucking awesome. The money part's been awesome. buying stuff for people I care about when it comes to, like, getting Christmas presents and or Valentine's Day stuff or games or small things like that. It's been pretty good. But what I noticed from working is that if you let the negative aspects just fucking hang and eat and claw and rip at your fucking conscience, because there could be some negative people there. There could be some people who could talk shit to you, make fun of you. Actually, it's not even make fun of you. It's just straight up talk shit, saying that this is a dead-end job, that you're not going to be going anywhere. Everything, this is where it ends. Your life ends here. You'll never go be, you'll never be able to travel. You'll never be doing anything along those lines. And it's very, very fucking depressing. And those words can be very real, because people who've worked there have worked longer than 2 months. You know, they've worked there for 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. There's someone who's worked there for 14 years. Hearing them state things like that can be a definite blow to your conscience, even though it's something that you do know and you probably shouldn't be worrying about too much. But all in all, I do like working there. It is stressful. The tax, the pain, how much it taxes my body is terrible. I'm exhausted. My back hurts. My right shoulder goes numb sometimes. I hurt my neck, I hurt my hand, I burned myself, I cut my finger open, I burned a hole into my thumb, which you can't see anymore because I think it fucking healed, but boy, it took the first fucking week of me working, it took for that to heal up, and this actually happened probably a month and a half ago, So all in all, I guess I can say I'm miserably content at where I'm working. There are some days where I feel like I'm just sitting and doing nothing, I'm not making any money, and it makes me feel terrible. I have a really good worth ethic. I've been getting all these little fucking little stars on this board, being like, hey, Luna or Alex did this, so we're gonna put this here, and you're gonna win a reward, depending on who has the most. So it's gonna be like situations like that. I do my best, even if the person before me didn't do their best. The kitchen heavily relies on people working together. The person before you setting you up. And sometimes there's people who don't set you up. There's sometimes people who dislike you when they purposely sabotage you, where dough isn't prepared, or ingredients aren't prepared, or they don't tell you. It's just shit like that. It isn't good. But with me working there, I've noticed with me working there, I noticed things kind of change, and stuff move. And people are actually helping and working together, and the people that got fired was definitely a big cancer on what the place was. Like I stated before, I'm miserably content. I really don't know what to do with the money that I have. I don't really have any plans or aspirations. I did have something, but that ended up getting taken away from me. I feel like I'm just working to just pass the time now. I'm terribly lonely. I feel like working destroyed one of my relationships. I feel like I'm being replaced, even with me leaving the server currently right now. And, hey, Hayden and Bilbo are gonna be the new power couple now. Okay? Instead of me and her. So until next time, as always, my name is Luna. Stay frosty. I don't even know if I'm joking about that. I'm so fucked up, guys. I'm so fucked up right now, but I don't know. I got work to do. I gotta take a shower. I'm gonna eat my Pop-Tarts that I've always wanted. And I'm gonna drink my chalky milk. So, until next time, as always, stay frosty. Love your faces.